What's up, everybody? So we are back today with a new review, the Dprofy. To be honest, I'm not really sure how we pronounce it. We're gonna start with this unboxing. This company reached out to me via Instagram and asked me to review their speaker, and I said, you know what, I do love a good speaker, and I'd love to get the opportunity to review it. So let's see if this is worth it, and if it can replace, you know, if you want a speaker, is this low priced option worth it? So let's open up this box and see what we got. And that's what I kind of see here. 1.5 hours full charge, whatever that means. Let's open it up. Let's take everything out of the box. There's the instruction manual here. Let's grab all this, what appears to be a charging cable. This block thing. And the instruction manual. So let's take a look at the actual thing. We don't need the box anymore. Whoop, whoop. All right, there we go. All right, so 1.5 hours full charge. Use the standard Type-C charging cable. Love that it comes with the USB Type-C. That's nice. And yeah, there we go. Fast charging, so it'll only take an hour and a half to get a full charge out of this thing on the backside. Don't play music when using the power bank function. So this thing right here, there's the speaker. Looks kind of nice. Feels decent in the hand, kind of heavy. Not too bad. There's your controls up there. Bluetooth, looks like it's got a phone feature. All types of stuff. So we're going to compare this to a pretty basic JBL Flip speaker that I currently have in my bag. But so far, just in the unboxing, it is a speaker, USB-C, an aux cable. That's not something you see much anymore. And we'll go through some of the features. We'll link it up and let's see how it does. Dprofy speaker, and took it out on the course when I was out in Vegas on vacation. And this little thing makes some noise, but rather than just me telling you that it makes some good noise and it sounds pretty good, we're going to compare it to the one that's been in here for a while. We got the JBL Flip. So I'm going to play it for both of you, or I'm going to play them both for you guys. You guys can kind of make your own decision on it. But some of the things I did notice, some of the good was that I really like the magnet on the back of this. So this magnet here really sticks to the cart really well. But that does lead to some problems. If you are listening to something with even a little bit of bass, it starts to shake the entire cart and you sound like a car with really bad speakers in the back. You can hear like that kind of shaking. If you've ever been around a car that is like that, that's kind of what you're getting here with this speaker when you attach it to the cart. So that was kind of funny. But overall, I thought it sounded pretty good. Like about it is the form factor. So it's pretty small when you compare it to the JBL Flip. If I put them both up, you know, you can see the JBL Flip is a little bit bigger overall. Overall, I thought it sounded pretty good. Like I said, some of the negatives is it does seem to be kind of rattly when you attach it to the cart. The other big problem I had with it was I kind of hate the controls up here. So you can see these controls here. Let's see, I can focus, make it a little bit better. So here you kind of look at them. You got your power here, play, pause, your Bluetooth connection. Then you got this plus minus right here. So for me, I thought plus minus meant my sound goes up or my sound goes down on the speaker. And it does do that, but you actually have to long hold it to get it to turn up, or long hold it to get it to turn down. If you just hit the button once or twice and you kind of rapidly do it, it actually changes it to the next song. So kind of a weird thing there, something that I wasn't a huge fan of, but let's see how they sound. All right, so I'm a hip hop guy. I prefer that. So heavy bass is always good with me. I always want to make sure that we have a good amount of bass and that it sounds pretty clear. So let's take a listen to one of my favorite hype up songs, Going Bad by Meek Mill and Drake on this one.
Smoking legal. I got more slaps than the Beatles. Foreign shit running on diesel, dog. Playing with my name, this shit is lethal, dog. Who you see? What? Don Corleone.
To play music for everybody, here's a little bit of Morgan Wallen on the Dprofy.
Last night we let the liquor talk. I can't remember it, but we said it all. You told me that you wish I was somebody you never met.
Maybe a little yacht rock is a little bit more your style here. So here is, I want to say, let's take a look. We got Jesse's Girl from Rick Springfield coming up. As an example, I wanted to show you guys what it's like when you actually like try to turn this thing up by using the arrows. If you don't do it properly and you don't actually hold it down like you're supposed to, which again I think is kind of weird. If I see a plus or a minus, I'm gonna think that I need to use that to turn the volume up. But if you just press it once, it's a new song. But you can see if I hold it, it turns it up. Again, kind of weird. One thing that I also think is kind of weird with this is it doesn't actually change the volume of the speaker. It actually uses the Bluetooth connection on your phone, so it'll actually turn the sound down on your phone. And I know on some of other speakers, if I turn that down, I can still leave the speaker completely high on sound and then turn it down for my phone. But I can also turn the speaker down, like if I'm close to it. So it's just one of a little thing that I'm not a huge fan of. All right, so as you can see, this is my well-used and abused JBL Flip. I've had it for, gosh, 6-7 years. So this is an older version. But let's see how those same songs sound on the JBL.
Show me what you gotta do. Bring the clip back empty. You asked to see the ball, so they sent me, y'all. I just broke off with a 10-piece, dog. There ain't nothing, I'm just being friendly, dog.
All right, so next up, just like with the Dprofy, Dprofy, however you pronounce it, let's listen to, if you're more of a country person, let's listen to a little Morgan Wallen here.
That you wish I was somebody you never met, but baby, baby, something's telling me this ain't over yet. No way it was our last night.
All right, here we go. A little bit more Rick Springfield for you. Let's see how it sounds on the JBL. And just to kind of show you, if I hit the sound button, if I hit the plus button, it just turns it up. So the down button just turns it down. Now, I will say the JBL doesn't give me the ability to change songs like this speaker does, which is kind of nice. But I think I'd like it a little bit more if they flip the buttons on here to say that, like, oh, this is to increase your sound, this is to decrease your sound. Long hold for the change on the song. Cool features about this speaker. I already mentioned that it's magnetic. That's pretty cool for that. Right here, you can actually slip in an SD card. So if you want to put your music on an SD card so you don't have to have your phone. Some people don't like having their phone on the course, so you put all that on the SD card. That's pretty cool. It does fast charge. So you can get 80% charge in about an hour is what they're claiming. And it's also got an aux cable here, so if you want to use it as an aux. But another really cool thing it does is instead of charging, it can actually be used as a power bank. Now, they do recommend you don't use the speaker while you're using it as a power bank. But if you find yourself out on the course and your phone starts to get a little bit low, you turn off the speaker, you lose tunes for a couple of holes, but you have the ability to still charge your phone and make sure you can call that Uber Home or something like that. So pretty cool little nifty feature in there, in addition to the waterproof and the dustproofness, which is always important out on the course, because all it takes is one rain shower for you to lose your speaker, and that is never fun. I think one of the most important things for a speaker like this is when you think about it out on the golf course, if you're going to use it out there, which is what this is kind of designed to do, it needs to have good sound coming out from the sides. And while there's no like speaker cans there, I was clearly able to hear it out on the course when I stood by the ball. Because what's typically going to happen is you're going to park next to your ball on your cart, and you're going to walk up and hit your shot, and you could still hear it while you're doing that. So a really nice sound coming from the sides there. The magnetic feature was strong, held on to the cart for pretty much my whole round unless I took it off. So lots of pluses there. All right, so that's kind of it for the review here. Overall, I think this speaker sells for $60 on Amazon. I definitely think it's worth the $60. Do I think the JBL probably sounded a little bit better? Yeah, I do. But the JBL Flip tends to run $80-$90, I believe. So I think you can save $30, get a pretty good speaker. When you're out on the course, sound quality, not exactly the best. As long as it's got a little bit of bass, a little bit of sound to it, it can get kind of loud, but not too loud. I think overall, it's got some quirks to it, right? The plus, minus, like I said, makes it a little bit... little bit of a pain, but overall, easy connection. I mean, you turn it on, you turn the Bluetooth on your phone on, pops right up. Super easy to use in that term. The waterproofness, the dustproofness, the fact it can be used as a external charger as well, makes it a pretty good buy for $60. If you are somebody who deeply cares about sound quality, may not be the right one for you, but I love the magnetic back. I think it sounds good enough. When I put it on the cart, it did shake the cart with its base a little bit. But I kind of overcame that, just kind of threw it in the cage in the back. So overall, I think it's worth the $60. I don't think you will be wasting your money with it. It's going to work as a speaker. These speakers have gotten less and less expensive over the years. So $60 for one of these, not too bad.